From the stage.
We put out 5 CDs, traveled the world, so many tours.
Can I get a witness in here?
To the pulpit.
I never wanted to be up front. I never wanted to pastor a big church.
Bishop Brian Pierce Sr. has traveled a winding road. Greensboro native Isaac Currie invited him to join a newly formed gospel group, Men of Standard, while they toured with a gospel stage play in the early 2000s. His initial response,
I'm done with that. When I leave the road, I'm going to start pastoring. He said, just pray about it, man, pray about it. Me and my wife prayed about it, and God told us yes.
The Pierces moved to Greensboro, and they joined Mount Zion Baptist Church soon after. He was offered a job as a staff pastor, and he later moved to Concord to pastor there, all while he was still touring. It was on tour that he says he heard God speak.
I need you to go back home and dedicate full time to pastoring.
He eventually came back to Mount Zion and was promoted to senior pastor in 2013. But he says he couldn't escape the thing that brought him here.
Had so many people to say, okay, when are you going to do a solo project? When are you going to do it? I was like, no, that's not me. No, I'm good.
In 2016, gospel superstar Tasha Cobbs Leonard asked him again.
Before I could think about it and give thought to it, the answer came, yes, I'm ready. You know, and I was like, oh, goodness, what did I do?
Pierce recorded Glory live at the church, and it debuted at number 3 on the Billboard charts this summer. Its theme came out of his desire to take the Mount Zion experience to the masses.
Whenever the glory of God was released in the place, it created an opening for miracles, for healing. And so we did not want it to be contained here at 1301 Alamance Church Road or in the city of Greensboro.
Bishop Pierce says he never wants to be known just for his 5,000-member congregation.
I want to be known for the bags of groceries that we give out. We want to be known for the gas giveaways, that the things we do in the community to help people that can never do anything for us.
He's been so good.
He recently released a book about his journey.
I didn't see all of this. There was no book in my future, no solo project in my future. I didn't see the growth of this ministry and everything that's happening today. All God wanted was for me to tell him yes through the transition.
And he hopes his life encourages people to step out of their box like he did, because you never know what's waiting for you. Tracy Clemens, Fox 8 News.